Welcome to Coal Watch, our monthly series designed to provide you with insight and analysis on the global coal market. I'm James O'Connell, the editorial director of Coal at Platts. This month, we're going to take a look ahead at CIF ARA's coal swaps, benchmark and 5500 Newcastle markets, and finally, we'll swing by China for a close inspection of the China Coal Index 1 and 8. On June 6th, CIF ARA calendar 2015 thermal coal swaps slumped under $80 a tonne for the first time since early April, and at their lowest level for a year-ahead contract in over 4.5 years. Down $2 on week, our sources are pointing to aggressive selling in the market due to high port stocks, ample availability in the Atlantic, and low coal burn in Europe. Recent price falls in UK natural gas prices are not helping matters either. On this side of the planet, benchmark Newcastle thermal coal is inching ever closer to that psychological support level of $70 a tonne, currently hovering at $72 per tonne. The last time it was this low was in quarter four 2009. There was some speculation at Coal TransAsia that prices could fall to the mid-60s, which would prove a five-year low. To do this, Macquarie Bank suggests it would require a further substantial deterioration in the Chinese market, which it said is unlikely in the short term. For close to 2 years now, Australian producers have been on a major cost-cutting drive. The larger miners have an ability to produce a wide range of high CV thermal coals, targeting, for example, the high-end Japanese market, the Korean 55 to 5700 market at the 20% ash level, and of course the Chinese market at 5500, 23% max ash level. The Platts 20% ash Newcastle 5500 price is about $63 per tonne, or about $61.35 for 23% ash using our ash differential tool. At the right-hand side of the graph, you can see that the trend is firmly on the downside. There are further interesting times ahead, as we reported a couple of weeks ago that Xinhua, at the very start of June, discounted their higher-end CV products by 5 RMB. This has already fed into lower FOB offers from Australian producers for prompt and July delivery cargoes. The very latest from our sources in China, and it's news that we ran in CTI on June the 11th, is that Xinhua are about to introduce a further 20 RMB discount. High stocks at Chinese power plants and seaports have continued to deter Chinese buyers from booking July and August delivered overseas thermal coal. Power plants have been maintaining their stock levels very carefully so as to better manage their risk management strategies. Panic buying or panic selling by Chinese traders has also led to their dumping of some spot 5500 NAR Australian coal into the market at about 515 to 520 RMB for CFR South China. And this accounts for the more pronounced downside trend if you were, for example, to compare the CCI 1 and the CCI 8 at the more recent end of the trend and the curve. This discounting move by Xinhua could put serious pressure on the 500 RMB level and in turn affect prices in the wider 5500 international markets. It is exactly these kind of events that really illustrate why you need daily transparent and independent data sets that illustrate the arbitrage opportunities. Comparing the CCI1 in green and the domestic marker here in orange, it's plain to see that the Platts Fenway price reacts quicker to moves on the upside, calls the downturn, and equally the bottom of the market weeks ahead of the domestic rival. When you plot the exact spread between the indices with the CCI1 at zero, you can see a significant difference between the domestic competitor and being as much as 40 RMB out of the market quite recently here in February. To track our CCI indices and for all the latest prices and market comment and news, do please pick up the latest edition of Coal Trader International. And in the meantime, happy trading. We'll be right back.